Hi guys, welcome to Derive. So in today's video, we're going to start our machine design review by answering this past board exam problems. Siyempre, mag-start tayo sa introduction ng machine design, and we're all familiar that the start or the beginning of a machine design subject is all about strength of materials or summary of strength of materials topic. So expect na ang ating mga questions here is strength of materials. Siyempre, sa mga susunod naman na araw, ay mag-upload tayo or mag-upload tayo ng mga videos ng mga deeper chapter for the machine design. Siyempre, kailangan nating simulan sa basics. So, samahan niyo ako. So, let us start this one. Okay, so, as you can see kanina, balikan ko lang konti. So, this is a part one. So, I will upload, depende sa dami ng questions na mariretrieve ko. No, so ito ay part 1, so 5 items. Sa part 2 meron tayong another 5 items that will be uploaded later. Okay, so start tayo. So I will read the question first. Determine the minimum diameter of a taper pin to use in fixing a lever to a 2 inches diameter shaft if it is to transmit a torque of 700 inches pound. Use an allowable stress of 15 KSI. So determine the minimum diameter of a taper pin daw, no, in fixing a lever. So kunyari, meron tayong diameter 2 inches diameter shaft dito. So ayoko na ayusin mo naman yung bilog yan. So kunyari andito yung shaft natin na meron daw 2 inches diameter. And syempre, sabi, dihanap yung diameter ng taper pin to use in fixing a lever to a 2 inches diameter shaft. So, ibig sabihin, yung shaft na ito ay inapplyan ng isang lever. Kunyari, nandyan yung lever natin. Yan. Kunyari lang. Yan. So, nandyan yung lever natin. And nakapasok siya dito sa 2 inches diameter shaft natin. Okay. And siyempre, may in-apply tayong torque of 700 inches pounds. And siyempre, ang inaanap minimum diameter of taper pin. So somewhere here, nandiyan yung taper pin because taper pin is somehow similar also to a key. So siyempre, andito yung taper pin natin. Okay? So since inaanap is diameter, syempre yung pin natin dyan is bilog. So keys are rectangular, di ba? Pero ito naman taper pin na hinahanap is circular. So meron siyang small d diameter. Okay? So ibig sabihin, pwede rin natin or gawin natin 2 inches diameter is represented by capital D. And syempre, kung may in-apply na torque, may force na mag-a-act dun sa taper pin, which is in this direction. So I will draw a plus sign here as a center of the shaft diameter. So we're going to search for the minimum diameter of a taper pin given 2 inches diameter shaft, torque of 700 inches pound, and allowable stress of 15 KSI. So our allowable stress is 15 KSI or 15,000 PSI. And this allowable stress, no, ay nag-act dun sa taper pin, which is a shearing stress o pagkapunit caused by the torque. And as a formula of F over A, okay, so that will be F divided by area ng taper pin, which is circular, that will be pi over 4 small d squared. And this will be a direct substitution sana kung meron lang tayong force agad. And we're going to have our small diameter of the taper pin. Kaso wala tayong F. So, saan tayo kukuha? Okay, so since meron tayong torque dito na nag-act, so we can have a summation of moment for the center of shaft. So, meron tayong nag-act na torque, which is on this direction. And meron din tayong nag-act na force naman dito. So, ibig sabihin, F times, ano ba yung perpendicular distance niya mula sa center? So, that will be, so, syempre, radius ng diameter mo or can be represented by D over 2, capital D over 2. So, torque is equal to force times capital D divided by 2. So, our F will be come 2T over D. So, that will become 2 times 700 divided by diameter, which is 2 inches, so that will be 700 pounds. Okay, so meron tayong F dito, which is 700 pounds, and meron tayong allowable stress of 15,000 psi or 15 ksi. So we're going to get the taper pin diameter. So, ayan, calculator, guys. So that was 7,000 divided by 0.25 pi and divided by 15,000. So the square root of that will be 0.77. Tama ba? Okay, so ulit. So that was 725 pi times 15,000 square root of d. So pakikompare-compute na lang. So that will become 0.24 inches. Okay, so that will be our answer. Kaso ang nasa choices is millimeter. So we need to convert this first. We all know that in sa isang inch, meron tayong 25.4 mm. So multiply yung 0.24 by 25.4. So we're going to add the 6.19 mm or 6.2 mm. Pangit ng mm natin. Ayan. Ayun. So we have our final answer for the diameter of taper pin as 6.2 millimeters. So nandyan yung sagot. Okay, so proceed tayo. Second question, compute the stress in megapascal on a 3 centimeter diameter, 100 centimeter long steel rod if its elongation caused by an axial load is 0.12 centimeter. Use modulus of elasticity or E is equal to 206,786 megapascal. So good thing given CE, no? As exactly as 206,786 megapascal. Pero pag walang sinabi, we can use the 210,000 megapascal as standard. So, inahanap stress in megapascal on a 3 centimeter diameter shaft and 100 centimeter long steel rod. If its elongation caused by an axial load is 0.12 centimeter. So, kunyari, ito yung rod natin, which has a length of 100 cm. And ayan daw, caused by axial load. So, kunyari, tension, nagkaroon ng elongation na 0.12 mm. So, kunyari, yan yung elongation. So, compute for the stress in mega pascals. So this is the cross section which has a diameter of 3 centimeter. So we all know that the formula for the deformation is PL over AE, where P is your axial load. Okay, kung ano yung in-apply mong force. So burahin pala natin ito. And so may in-apply kang force, syempre sa length nung kung anong object yung in-apply mo ng force. And we have this A as your cross-sectional area and E that stands for the modulus of elasticity. So, so meron tayong given daw na deformation of 0.12 centimeter. So this is a centimeter, sorry. And we're going to find the stress. So that was P L over A. E. So meron tayong L which is 100 cm, meron tayong E at as 206,786 megapascal. So how are we going to find the stress? So we all know that the stress is equal to force over area or axial load over area. And we can conclude that this P over A is equal to stress na. So sabi natin tensile stress, no? So ayan, unit analysis, cancel CCM here, cancel CCM here. And we're going to have a megapascals here. So, syempre, assume that the multiple choice are in megapascals. So, that will become 0.12 is equal to ST times 100 divided by 206,786. So, that will become ST is equal to 0.12 times 206,786 divide 100 and ayan, so we have 248.14 megapascals, which is our final answer. And tingnan natin sa multiple choice kung may malapit dito. So yun, so we have this 248. So the answer is letter B. Okay, so ano pa? How many? So third question, how many 5/16 inch holes can be punched in one stroke of, in a steel plate made of SAE 1010 steel, 7/16 inch thick, using a force of 55 tons. The ultimate strength force here is 50 KSI. So, kunyari meron tayong steel plate dito na gawa sa, what you call that? 1010 steel, SAE 1010 steel. At syempre, in one stroke, so, how many 5/16 inch holes? So, kunyari meron tayong 5/16 dito. Kunyari lang. Yan. 5/16 inches diameter of steel plate. How many 5/16 inch holes? So, ito yung 5/16 can be punched in one stroke in a steel plate made of SA 1010 steel. So, 7/16 inch thick. Ayan. So, 7/16 inch thick. Using a force of 55 tons. So, kunyari, meron tayong 55 tons na in-apply dyan or 55,000 pounds. So, the ultimate strength force here is 50 KSI or 50,000 PSI. So, ang hinahanap number of holes na pwedeng ma-punch sa isang punch nitong steel plate given yung material or ultimate strength of 50,000 PSI na may kapal na 7/16 at may diametrong 5/16 inch. So, in-applyan daw siya ng 55,000 pounds. So, how many holes? No? So, we all know that the stress is equal to force over area. And since the stress given is ultimate strength, so that will become force pa rin yung nasa baba over area. So, our area here is, what is our area here? So, ang area, syempre, ang in-applyan ng force is yung 5/16 inch diameter, so that will be ang area natin will become, so that will become circumference times the thickness. Why? Kasi si yung bilog, kapag yung bilog natin no, kapag tiniklop mo, syempre that will be the length of the circumference, which is pi d. So that the area will become pi d times thickness. So that will become pi d t is equal to 55,000 pounds divided by pi. Your diameter is 5/16 and your thickness is 7/16. Syempre, kung ano yung area, nandun kung ilan yung butas. So we can say that the number of bolts is on your denominator. Okay? So that will be letter N here is equal to 50,000 PSI. Okay, so unit analysis, pounds per inches squared is also the same as PSI, and you have your pounds here. You have your inches here. You have your inches here for thickness and diameter. So pounds per inches and inches. So that will become pounds per inches squared. So this will be canceled, and we're going to have the letter N or the N that represents the number of holes that is unitless. So our N will become, so mangyari dyan, 55,000, tapusin mo muna yung computation sa ilalim, divided by pi times 5, divided by 16, times 7, divided by 16. And yung answer niyan, divide mo dun yung 50,000 kasi magto-cross multiply yan. Okay, so that will become, ayan, 2.56. And syempre, our final answer will become 3. Okay. Kasi wala namang kalahating number nung holes, diba? So, it will be rounded off to N is equal to 3. Okay. So, hindi ko rin naman pwedeng sabihin, hindi man natin pwedeng sabihin rounded off, kaya naging 3. hindi kasi rin natin pwedeng gamitin yung 2. Why? Kasi once na ginamit mo yung 2, tataas yung value mo dito at malalagpasan mo yung value ng 50,000. So, kunyari gamitin ko yung n is equal to 2. Tingnan natin kung ano yung magiging SU. If n is equal to 2, our SU will be, so 55,000 divided by 2, kasi 2 holes, times the area pi, times 5, 16, times 7 divided by 16. So, that will become 64,000, di ba? So, malalagpasan mo yung allowable ultimate strength, which is mali, di ba? So, 2 is not the answer. So, the answer is 3, kung ano yung pinaka malapit. Okay? So, ano yung kulang konti? Pi times... So, yun. Correct. So, ang sagot natin is 3 holes. Okay? So, that was for the third question. And for the fourth question, a hollow nickel steel shaft whose outside diameter is twice... whose outside diameter is twice the outside diameter. So, meron tayong error. So, this should be inside. No? So, inside... whose inside diameter is twice the outside diameter? Tama ba? Whose inside diameter is twice the outside diameter or vice versa? Oh, medyo nalilito na rin no, si Engineer HB. So it should be, tama ito, whose outside diameter is twice the inside diameter? Is to transmit 1,492 kilowatts at 220 RPM, the shaft is subjected essentially to torsion. Assuming an allowable shear stress of 224 megapascal, determine the size of the hollow shaft required. So, as you can see guys, sa multiple choice, ang given lang or ang sagot lang is the capital D or yung outside diameter. So, no need to get for the small diameter, which is the inside diameter. So, let us start this. So, ang unang-unang given is whose outside diameter is twice the inside diameter. So, let us take the capital D as outside diameter and small d as inside diameter. And sabi, ang given is d na malaki is equal to twice daw nung inside diameter. Okay, so that was our first condition. And sabi, is to transmit 1,492 kilowatts. So our power is 1,492 kilowatts at 220 RPM. The shaft is subjected essentially to torsion. Assuming an allowable shear stress of 224 megapascal, determine the size of the hollow shaft. Ko lang ito. So, ang hinahanap is capital D kasi yun lang naman yung nasa choices. So, how are we going to do this? So, we all know that the shear stress that is when the shaft is subjected essentially to torsion, we have the shear stress is equal to 16T over pi D cube kapag hollow, ay kapag solid. Kapag hollow naman, we all know that the shear stress is 16TD divided by phi d raised to 4 minus d raised to 4 na maliit. Okay, so pwede nating sabihin na dito small d or the inside diameter is 1/2 nung outside diameter. Okay, so ayun. Pag pinasok natin small d rito, magiging in terms na siya ng capital D. So everything will be solved. Kung given lahat, no? We have the SS as 240 megapascals. And syempre, hinahanap natin capital D. So, we are going to insert this one dito. So, this will become D over 2. Ayun, pwede nating substitute kaso we have a missing piece which is the torque. So, saan natin siya pwedeng kunin? We all know, guys, na way back on our strength of materials, we have the formula of power is equal to torque multiplied by some speed, syempre divided by constant. So, kapag on metric tayo, we have this 9.549 times 10 raised to 6. So this is already derived. So if you want to see the derivation, meron ako niyan sa ating page. No, just click the link on the description, no. So in order for us to have our power here to be in kilowatts, our torque should be in Newton mm and our N here should be in RPM. So divide by some constant, which is 9.549 times 10 raised to 6. So meron tayong 1,492 kilowatts is equal to torque. Pangit ng letter T. So our letter N is 220 RPM. So ang denominator is 9.549 times 10 raised to 6. So expect that this torque na lalabas is in Newton mm. Kasi meron kang kilowatts dito, meron kang RPM dito, and some constant. So our torque will become Newton mm. So 1,492 times 9.549 times 10 raised to 6 divided by 220. So medyo malaki to. So that will become 64,759,581.82 Newton mm. Tama? Okay. So, dito naman ang unit analysis natin. Our shear stress here will should be in megapascals. Para maging megapascals yung shear stress mo dyan, our torque here should be in Newton mm. And all diameters should be in mm. Okay, so perfect. We have our torque in Newton mm. So expect na yung lalabas nating diameter is in millimeters. So pwede natin ito, para hindi na ako magsulat ng panibagong formula. So pwede nating sabihin na ito ay, pwede nating gawing 0.5D. So palitan natin ng bracket ito. So that will become 0.5D raised to 4. So do the math na lang, guys. So ganyan yung principle. You may use shift solve. So ako iisa-isahin ko na lang. Okay. So that will become, so paano natin kukunin ito? Yun nga, tingin ko kailangan talaga magsulat ng panibago. Okay. How are we going to do this? So, ayun. So, SS is 224. It's equal to 16 multiplied by the torque, 64,759,581.82 multiplied by D. And pi sa ilalim. And syempre, 0.5 raised to 4 muna natin. So that will become 1 over 16. So that will become 1 minus 1 over 16. And there we have it. We're going to have a 15 over 16D raised to 4. So saan nanggaling yan, guys? So ito yon. Parang lumalabas kasi yan. 1 raised to 4 minus 0.5 raised to 4. So dyan lumabas yung 15 over 16. So since may D ka dito sa taas at may D raised to 4 ka sa ilalim, so that will be canceled sa taas. And this will become cube. Okay, so our answer will be 16 times the torque. Divided by pi times 15 over 16 times 224 and cube nun. So we have this 116.239 mm. So meron ba tayong pinakamalapit? So, ayun, meron tayong letter C, which is 116.24 mm. Okay, so dito tayo sa last item for the part 1 of the introduction. A journal bearing with a diameter of 76.2 mm is subjected to a load of 4,900 newtons while rotating at 200 RPM. If the coefficient of friction is 0.2, 0.02, and the ratio of the length over diameter, or L over D, is equal to 2.5 pi in each projected area in millimeter squared. So I will draw a journal bearing. No? Kunyari, ayan. Ayan. Kunyari, ayan. So kunyari, top view. So kunyari, ito yung ano niya, holder. No, kunyari, may bolt dyan. May bolt dyan, may bolt dyan. So this is your bearing, your journal bearing. So ang hinahanap is, ito naman tayo. So pangit ang sulat. So ang hinahanap is find its projected area. So we all know that the projected area of a bearing, so ayan, kapag pinrojected mo yan, so para din talaga siyang triangle which has a length na ganyan, tapos meron ditong diameter, yan yung magiging projected area. So ang projected area, of course, ng rectangle is just as simply the product of length times width, and this will become length times diameter. So ganun lang kadali. So ang problema, meron ba tayong given na length and diameter? So meron daw tayong given na diameter, sabi 76.2 millimeters, kaso wala tayong L. Pero meron binigay na condition na L over D is equal to 2.5. So that will become L is equal to 2.5 diameter. So we're going to have an area of 2.5 diameter times diameter again. So that will become 2.5 diameter squared. So that will be 2.5 times, anong diameter natin? 76.2 squared. So mm yan. So we're going to have area in mm squared. So that was 76.2 squared times 2.5. And there you have it. We have the 14,516.1 square millimeter. So meron ba tayong closest answer? This is 14,165. So ayun, meron tayong 14,516 na answer here. Okay, so ayun, nakalima tayo agad na item for the introduction of machine design, and the part 2 of this video will be uploaded then later. So salamat sa pakikinig, guys. So patuloy nyo pong samahan sa pagre-review natin, no? Especially dito sa machine design and sa iba pang mechanical engineering subject. So ayun, kita-kits later sa ating mga iba pang videos. So salamat, guys, and God bless.